Hello guys, welcome back again. And in this video tutorial we are going to talk about habitat of algae. In my previous videos I already have talked about the classification of algae. If you haven't seen that, I will share a link in description below and you can go there and watch that too. So in this video we will only talk about habitat of algae. So let's see. So based on their habitat, their living area, we can divide them into three types: aquatic algae, second one terrestrial algae, third one algae of unusual habitat. Aquatic algae, it will be found in marine or freshwater area. This means it can be found in aquatic portion, it can be found in land portion, and it will be found unusual portion. You can say some rough condition portion, some rough condition environment habitat. Okay, so three type algae. So our first portion, aquatic algae. The algae are predominantly aquatic, and aquatic algae are two types. First of all, you need to know mostly algae are dominantly aquatic. They will be found in water. 75% algae habitat in water. So if you divide the aquatic algae again, then we can divide into two types. They can be found in fresh water or they can found in marine water. So let's see. First of all, benthophytes, it is the type of aquatic algae. Okay, we are not going into aquatic algae, freshwater algae or marine algae portion. Okay, we are going to talk about commonly portion of aquatic algae. Okay, let's see. Benthophytes, several freshwater and marine algae are found in a test condition. It means they you can find them by attaching into ground layer by substratum portion of their body. Okay, the freshwater such as Cara, Nitella, Cladophora, Semiosophon are found attached to some substratum in the bottom of the water. It means they are normally in water but attached to the ground by their substratum layer. We will call them benthophytes. Either they can be fresh algae or marine algae, but they will be attaching to the ground by their substratum portion. Example, you can see Cara, Nitella, Cladophora, almost all of brown algae. Fuficiae, I have talked about Fuficiae in our classification videos, are found in attached condition to some substratum in the sea. Okay. So most of the brown algae are found in attached condition. They are benthophytes because they are attached to the ground portion by their substratum. So it is benthophytes. Now we will talk about epistophytes. Such algae grow along the shores of lake and ponds. Okay, note, let's take an example. It is a lake. Okay, it's shore and it is left or right so portion of lake. If some of algae are found in this area, we will call them epistophytes. The most important freshwater forms are Oligonium, Cetophora, some species of Spirogyra, and Moigeata, some diatoms, and etc. etc. So they will be founding in source of lake and ponds. Okay, now talk about planktophytes. These algae which float on the surface of the water are called planktophytes. It means it is the layer of water. It is your sea or your lake, and it will be floating on the layer, and their root will not attach the ground like this. Okay, we will call them planktophytes. If you alternative divide them again, then we can divide them into two types. First one, euplanktophytes, and second one is trichoplanktophytes. First of all, we will talk about euplanktophytes. They are never attached, and from the very beginning are very free floating. It's mean it's the water layer, and their root will not attach to the ground. Okay, they are free floating plant. We will call them euplanktophytes, such as diatoms, microcystis, volvox, chlamydomonas. Okay, if you come to the trichoplanktophytes, in the beginning such algae are attached, but later on they became detached and free floating. It's mean during their germination time, during their early stage of life, they will be attaching to the ground. It is your lake, it is a lake layer portion, it is the ground portion. Okay, in early stage of life they are attached, but after germination, after spending some life, they will deattach and free float. If you talk about some examples, some species of Spirogyra, Cladophora, Oudoconium, Mygoeta, Tribonema, Microspira, Nostoc, Tetraspora, Sargassum. These are the example of trichoplanktophytes. Okay, so we have completed the portion of aquatic algae. Now we come to the terrestrial algae. Such algae are also called depophytes. They are found upon or inside the surface of the earth. They will be found in earth or surface of earth. Okay, it is your surface. They can be found here or inside of the earth. By these condition, we can also divide them again. One will be sapophytes. They are surface algae, these type of algae. Most of the species of Myxophysi are found upon the surface of the soil, like this Fusaria, and many other met with upon the surface of the wet soil. So you don't need to remember all of the example. Take some eminent example like Fusaria, Fresella. They will be found on the surface of the wet soil. Okay, we will call them sapophytes. If you come to the portion of cryptophytes, such algae are subterranean, inhabit and occur inside the soil. They will not found on the surface of the soil. They will only found inside of the soil. The species of Nostoc, Anabina, Euclina have been reported from the paddy field, where they also fix the atoms ferric nitrogen in the soil to increase the fertility of the fields. So in paddy fields, they help to enhance the nitrogen fixation capacity of the plants. Okay, we call these algae cryptophytes. Examples such as Nostoc, Anabina and Euclina. Okay, now we have talked about two types. First one aquatic, second one terrestrial. Now come to the unusual habitat having algae. First one, lithophytes. Many algae grow on the rock and walls. Most of the algae grow on rock and walls. The species of Cyctonema grow on the walls in rainy season, and the whole wall becomes black spotted. Such as Fusaria, Nostoc and many other algae are also found in wet rocks. So they are easy to easy to know, easy to recognize by their black spot, or such as Bausaria nostoc and many other also found on wet rocks. We will call them lithophytes, like these. Okay, now come to the halophytes. The algae occur in saline water are known as halophytes. They will be found in saline water. The most striking example are Dunalilia and Chlamydomonas, which occur in Salt Lake. Okay, you don't need to go into the depth of the example. Okay, now come to the epiphytes. Many algae are found upon other living plants and bigger species of algae. Okay, like these, Microspora, Oudogonium are found as epiphytes upon larger species of Oudogonium. So they will be found on another living plant or bigger species of algae, like this Coleochaete Nitellarium is epiphytic upon species of Cara and Nitella. So one algae is living on another bigger algae, we call that epiphytes. And some of the species of Colocadia are epiphytic upon some grasses grown on the bank of the pond, and the hydrophytes such as Vallisneria, Typha, so several other aquatic plants. Chitonema is found epiphytic on the mucilaginous moss of Tetraspora and Vetrosporum. So it is worthless, you don't need to remember all of the example. Just aerophytes. Now such algae are aerial in habit. Their root will be floating in air, free air. They are found upon the trunks of trees, walls, fencing, wires, rocks and animals, and so many other aerial substratum. These are two types, epiphyllophytes and epifoliophytes. Let's take a look at them. Epiphyllophytes, first one, like these, you can see algae are free floating. Such algae are epiphytic upon leaves of trees. Okay, epiphytic part, they are living on tree leaves. A species of like Trentifolia are commonly found upon the bark of trees. Bark of trees, okay. Epiphyllophytes, second, they also occur upon rock and fencing wires, and they are evidently found on the fencing wire of Calcutta Botanical Gardens. Okay, so these are the epiphyllophytes. Take example like this. So second one is epiphyllophytes. These algae grow on the bark of tree mixed with many mosses and liverworts. They are mixed with moss and liverworts too, like Formidium grow on the bark of tree mixed with liverworts. So these are the example. And next, algae is epizoophytes. Certain algae are found on living aquatic animals such as turtles, mussels, fishes. Like a species of Cladophora grow upon mollusk cells. Okay, epizoophytes mean living on animals. Cryophytes, these algae are found in ice and snow. These algae form cause red snow, green snow, yellow snow, yellowish crown snow and violet snow. Okay, in European countries, especially in Arctic tundra region, the green snow is caused by Chlamydomonas and Mesotanium, and red snow is caused by species of Chlamydomonas scotiella glossiepsa. Okay, as you can see, it is the example of red snow. You can call it buttermelon snow, snow algae, pink snow, blood snow, caused by Chlamydomonas nivalis. It is the most example, comes in various objective exam. Who is the cause of red snow? You need to remember Chlamydomonas nivalis. Red snow is this, like this, basically Pseudomonas nivalis. It is microscopic portion, you can see in green snow. It is green snow is caused by Chloromonas chinogenosis and Chloromonas togeliensis. So you can see green snow. Okay, it's not grasses, it's the color of snow. So it is the all three type of algae we have talked about. First one aquatic, second one terrestrial, third one unusual habitat. So these are the habitat of algae. So I hope you will get all the portion of the types. So thanks guys for watching.